Hey, funny looking. Zira needs you in the den. Said she has something for you. Something about a bastard who forced silver claw from his own warehouse. Cash, I think. Some fancy pantaloon merchant lord who might be after the guild's old records. Zira's in the den. Don't keep her waiting. Haven't heard the name before Zira said it. Some new merchant lord trying to make a name, but don't they all? Used to be, the Thieves Guild knew every move the merchant lords made. Sad times, sad times. Like Herons we did. Our old guildmaster, who's a master at keeping their attentions on each other, made it easier to slip our heads into their pockets. Oh, Nicholas. The next 5 drinks are to your memory. Bunch of jumped-up bandits, if you ask me. Claim to run the whole city because they buy from anyone. As if throwing gold at pirates made them lordly. Without a steady flow of plundered goods, they'd be nothing.
You are. Remember Velsa's friend, Silverclaw? He is quite grateful you recovered his ledger. Seems he kept his ears open for word of that merchant lord, Kosh. If Kosh took over Silverclaw's warehouse, he's grabbing the rackets we used to control. And if he's after our old business, there's a good chance he's hungry for even more. Skooma trade, slavery, things we never touched. Before we give Kosh a swift kick to the coin purse, I want you to find out just how dirty his hands are. I sent the others ahead to do some groundwork. Start with walk softly. Look for him near the harbor. I sent Quinn to her own task, and Velsa too. Didn't even second guess me. She must be up to something. When Nicholas was guildmaster, I convinced him to stop dealing with Skooma peddlers. No matter my own thoughts on that poison, it's bad for business. And the Thieves Guild never dealt in slaves. One of the few things Velsa and I agree on. Not enough. Some of the merchant lords prefer to bide their time in obscurity, using trusted servants to handle their affairs. Then they reveal themselves, like a beetle in the pudding. Whatever Kosh intends, he's no longer keeping to the shadows.
Foolish talk makes me drunk. I don't like you when I'm drunk.
action.
You're right on time. What did our esteemed guildmaster tell you? Good, because I found something. The captain of the Dream Snake was always interested in making fast coin. She's sloppy, even for a pirate, which makes her a perfect target for Kosh. She and I have unpleasant history. Best I keep away from her. She's meeting a contact nearby. She's prone to boast. Why not find a quiet place to hear what she has to say? But the captain is a creature of habit. She used to keep documents secured in the Dream Snake. Try there, if you don't care to eavesdrop. Find what you can. After that, meet Quen near the harbor. She has her own task and will no doubt need your assistance. I once told the captain I was a wealthy Argonian prince seeking a fast ship to transport my riches. She let me inspect the smuggling compartments, and then I robbed her blind. She just has one eye patch, so half blind. I left her the eye patch. Harpy egg. They're sickening. I'd never actually eat one, but they're garish enough to draw attention from me. People see the Argonian with disgusting harpy eggs, not the Argonian with amazing fashion sense.
If you have nothing to say, say nothing.
Greetings.
I have many fine goods.
Everybody pays, sooner or later.
Reveal our Skooma supplier to some merchant lord who wants a cut.
It doesn't matter. It is Kosh demanded I come along to Noshir Citadel.
The Iron Wheel's headquarters? How is he involved with... No, don't tell me. Best you meet him before the Iron Wheel sends soldiers after us both.
Zira said I should wait for you when I was finished. Well, I'm finished. The flooded district, near where Velsa called home? The people who lived there had nowhere to go after the floods. One of the dockyard bosses offered them work, food, and a place to stay. That's what I told Zira. You know what she said? If Zolguk had an altruistic bone in his body, he'd cut it out and sell it. I'd already know what he was really up to, if Zira trusted me. But she wanted me to scout, and you to do the fun part. Zolguk arranged a meeting with an Imperial client at a nearby inn. Might be worth a listen. Oh, the inn rents a room to Ventilius Proximus, the most Imperial name I've ever heard. Probably the client. The room's lock seemed inadequate. Find Velsa when you're done. She's meeting with Silverclaw at his shop. Did you know he had a shop? I wonder what he sells. It's nothing. It's nothing. How could it not be? It's so difficult to care about all this. If I studied harder at the academy, I'd have graduated sooner. He would have traveled to see the ceremony. He wouldn't have been here when... I know, but when I tell that to myself, it feels like a lie. Listen to me, go on. I won't delay you any further with my ramblings. That's good to hear. See you later, partner.
Supposed to tell anyone about our...
I need your volunteers for my experiments. I would never ruin things for my supplier.
Then how did this Kosh know of our business?
I have no idea. But if you can't deliver warm bodies, I'll find another supplier.
Then pray I return from Noshira Citadel. If Kosh is connected to the Iron Wheel, we're both doomed.
My larcenous friend! Quickly! We must speak!
A most regrettable welcome, for I have such unfortunate tidings! What I soon reveal shall be quite distressing to hear. For this, I offer my gravest and most humble apology.
Ah, the look on your face is unmistakable!
It says, if I may speak for your most resplendent face, peace, my exceptionally sleek mercantile friend. Take a series of deep, relaxing breaths so you may reveal the matter at hand. In. Out. In. Out.
Velsa left for Noshira Citadel!
She made me promise upon our long and profitable friendship not to reveal this, but your vigorous interrogation left me no choice. I do not know why she travels to the headquarters of the Iron Wheel, but I fear for her safety. Go after her, of course. But you are so striking. The Iron Wheel will know you don't belong. It is settled. You shall meet with the illustrious Perseus Loke at the Diamond Thimble. He shall help you obtain an appropriate disguise. Tell him I sent you.
Velsa assured me she would not venture beyond the outskirts of Noshira Citadel. Assured me!
Oh my. With all certainty, she is already captured.
A cherished friend. Though not always.
Once, we were fierce rivals for the importation of fine silk. Yet, he proved the gracious victor and reimburses for any referral to this day. A cherished former rival, in all truth, but quite magnanimous.
Thank you.
customs are unfamiliar to you. That was illegal.
Hold still. Your attire is... That isn't a bloodstain, is it? Oh, did he now? Something striking, so you stand out at the next Merchant Lord's soiree, or a ridiculous crenellated affair that leaves you the talk of the brothel? Well, if you wanted a burial suit, the Iron Wheel charges far less than I. Though perhaps... Yes. A servant's outfit will let you go hither and yon, at least above ground, and if it's one of my creations, the cloth will breathe, but it shall cost you. Well, then I'd assume you're from Abar's Landing, but I know of a certain individual who has yet to pay the bill for just such an outfit. If you happen to reacquire it on my behalf, I would consider it your property, paid in kind. I'd prefer you deprived my shirker of his outfit, but if you're averse to saving coin, I will sell you one directly. Be warned, the disguise won't do you any good within the Iron Wheel's headquarters. Paranoia, of course. No servants are allowed inside. From what I hear, the Iron Wheel takes care of all chores within their headquarters. Anyone who isn't Iron Wheel or escorted by them is attacked on sight. A truly noble organization. I am physically capable of doing so, but it will never happen. I'd rather not end up in a prison cell. And a uniform alone won't serve as a disguise. They have too many signals and mannerisms. Why, you'd be spotted in an instant.
Thank you. Oh, look. You're hardly worthy.
So you got Silverclaw to spill a secret. At best, a minor accomplishment. He didn't send you to that powdered hornbill, did he? Buy a special uniform to fit in? You do know he gets referral for everyone he sends to that flax peddler? Even when he thinks my life is in danger, Silverclaw still works the angles. You bumpkin. Yes, I did. You're not supposed to throw my words back at me. Reminds me of Nicholas. I don't care if you are her protege. I'm not going to do Zira's scut work. I slipped a truth serum to Silverclaw's former overseer. I learned that Kosh blackmails assorted scum and draws them to Noshira Citadel for a meeting. So let's find out why. It seems Kosh contacts Little Fish from a position of power, threatens exposure, and bends them to his will. Elegant. What I'd do. But his connection to the Iron Wheel isn't clear. That troubles me. We. Now that Zira's protege is here, poor old Velsa can rest her weary bones. Find a way into the Iron Wheel's headquarters and learn how they're connected to Kosh. Oh, and blackmail needs documents. Be sure to swipe them. Zira tells me you're a thief. Go break into a place you shouldn't be. Take something valuable and leave before they notice. I did hear something about a passphrase for a service door. Look around, use your brain. I won't spoon-feed you. When you find what you need, get out and head back to the den. Don't get caught, and if you do, bite off your tongue before their torture forces you to shriek my name. You'll be fine. Nothing worth my time. And everything led here, didn't it? If we leave, we miss this opportunity to learn Kosh's plans.
Thank you.
What self-respecting person.
What is the fate of the Lawbreaker? What is the fate?
What is the fate?
What of those who would enter and find peace within?
Thank you.
I thought my shift would never end. Wait, who are you?
Don't hurt me! I'm not even an officer!
Please, I'm no threat to you. I simply watch the door.
6 days before I take my pension. I want no trouble, you see?
All servants are banned from our headquarters on pain of interrogation. Not that I call you a liar, simply that what you say cannot be at all correct. But I do not care to know your truth. Leave me be and I shall forget you completely.
Thank the gods! You will have no trouble from me. You were never here and I never saw you.
I have a sleeping draught. One sip helps me through the night. The whole bottle will knock me out for hours. You'll be long gone.
This is your only chance to consider my proposal. Work for me, or else. Or I hand these documents to the Iron Wheel. They do so frown on slavery and skooma peddling. Take a moment to consider your options. Well?
What choice do we have? Vrain!
Good. Then I shall make your documents disappear. What? My papers were here. Did they fall behind them? I'll attend to that after my meeting with Chief Inspector Ron Beek. Do remember who holds your reins. I can locate Magnifica Falora's dowry. I can return it to you within the fortnight.
And what is your interest in the matter? Exactly.
The Iron Wheel must leave Hughes Bane. He is simply bad for business.
If you recover Magnifica Falora's dowry, I can guarantee our return to Tanith.
There is another minor request. Hardly a trifle. Perhaps we can discuss it over drinks?
I do not drink.
Then I shall take your share. Come, an office is no place to do business.
Thank you.
You see, Zira, your protege returns having survived the invulnerable Iron Wheel. You should have more faith.
Everyone, clear the room. Velsa told me you went into the Iron Wheel's headquarters by yourself. What in oblivion were you thinking? We're not ready to go anywhere near the Iron Wheel. I won't have anyone else die because of a choice. Listen. I'm barely holding this together. No offense to Quinn, but you're the best recruit we have. I can't lose you to a feud with Velsa. You're right. You weren't around when they pulled our friends from their homes. They don't have the same kind of hold on you. Good to know. So tell me, when you explored their headquarters, fearlessly explored, did you find anything we can use? Impossible! It's still in Magnifica Flora's family tomb. The dowry heist failed. Nicholas and the others died before we reached the treasure vaults. No, the Iron Wheel was here to punish us for attempting the heist. But if that's what you heard, were they really searching for the dowry all along? Why come after us with such ferocity? What else did you learn? Let me see. This is comprehensive. Elaborate details on merchant lords in Abba's Landing, as well as rivals throughout the region. Maps to stolen goods we could recover for ourselves. I'll go through what you recovered, see if it offers a clue to Kasha's plans, or anything involving the missing dowry. I need to make sense of all this. Get some rest. I'll need you ready when we make our move. And good job. I keep thinking about what you found. If someone stole Magnifica Flora's dowry, it wasn't the Thieves Guild. But we certainly took the fall for it. What about? Nicholas told Velsa he was planning a heist, but she retired before he shared the details. I'm the only one who knew. Someone must have followed us to the tomb. The merchant lords see the Iron Wheel as an occupying force. They fear Tanith wants to conquer Abba's Landing. If Kosh convinces Chief Inspector Ranbeek to leave, he'll have immense influence. Must be his plan.